Very good morning to all the students of class plus 2C. So we are going to start with speech writing today. Okay. Most of you, you know, most of us, we all face problem when we communicate with one another or with teacher or with at any place. You know, these days, it is the need of the hour that you need to express yourself. It is a skill only. Communication is a skill. As you can see, I have written, I would be sharing, you can say broader view. I would be showing each and every point on the board. I'll be explaining to you. But before that, I would like to, converse with you all about this. How many of you want to go abroad after your plus two? There will be many, I guess. Send me thumbs up or raise your hand whatsoever. How many of you? I'm not saying going abroad is bad. I'm not saying going abroad is good. I'm just asking. I'm just going to tell you how important your communication skills are. Whether you will be going abroad or whether you will be staying here in any of the professions, whether you will be an accountant because you're the commerce students, whether you'll be working in banks, fine, most of you will be handling your own personal businesses, family businesses, and others will be doing jobs in MNCs. Or any, you can say, higher level companies, or many can be teachers also. So the crux of my conversation is, yes, Sukman Jyoti is saying maybe I'll be doing job after completing my education. So see, there are an N number of directions. And these days it's not that one will work or other, boys and girls, both are equals now. Everyone have to work, I feel so. And this is the need of the hour. You can't sit idle at home. So point here is that whatever direction you would be choosing in your lives, whether it's a job or a business, you need to communicate with people. Fine, you need to interact with lots of people. So you should know the art of speaking. Fine. That how to put forth your viewpoint in front of others. Though it is a very simple skill, you might be thinking this is speech writing and we'll be writing in boards and we will be getting marks, but it's above than that. Fine. Why? Because in boards, you will be getting speech writing. You can get 10 on 10, 9 on 10, 8 on 10 if you write in a very good manner. But this skill will also help you when you're standing on stage and speaking to audience. You never know, you will be doing it in future. Or when you are in any company, you're the team leader, suppose, and you're talking to many co-mates, you need to address anyone, a small gathering, maybe a one person even you're talking to, you should know that how to put forth your viewpoint. Fine, so what is a speech? Speech, whatever you will be expressing your own opinion, you will be just voicing your opinion in front of others. Fine. So we're not wasting much of the time. I would be okay. Let's start. All the points that are kindly note down. I would ask you to show me your notebook when I'm done with the points. Then I will show you the samples of speech. Okay. So first of all, I have written. One quotation, beta. One quotation is written here. That is, good communication is the bridge between confusion and clarity. What does it mean? That, you know, there is a very thin line between how you express yourself. Sometimes, you know, I just give you one example. Three small children were going to school all alone. I stressed upon the word three, that I want to say three. I'm stressing upon number. Three small children were going to school. Now I'm stressing upon the word small. Means they're fine. Getting my point. the way we speak beta, fine, and connotation, the meaning comes out of it, fine. In that way, the way we speak, how you are conveying message to the person standing in front of you. So you should know how to communicate. So good communication is the bridge between confusion and clarity. There is a bridge you have to cover. You have to start from confusion to clarity. Fine. You should choose your words wisely. Sometimes some students are very good at expressing themselves. On the other hand, there are students who keep on thinking, okay, how to start? What should I write? Then they forget, then they mix up and end up with confusion. That even checker or the listener, they're not able to perceive what the person is making you to understand. Fine. So let's start. I have bifurcated the paragraphs. This is a speech writing that you will be writing the speech. So that's why in first paragraph, start with the quotation, introduce yourself, announce the topic and occasion. Three things beta, note down. Start with a quotation. Suppose you have write a speech on good communication skills only. So you start this quotation. Good communication is the bridge between confusion and clarity. A very good morning to all the, you can say, fine, in that way. So you will start with a quotation and then you will greet the audience. Fine. I just missed one point. Start with the quotation and then greet the audience. Clear? And then introduce yourself. Greet the audience means wish the audience. And you should know what sort of audience is sitting in front of you, whether they are people of very renowned, you can say, positions, dignitaries are sitting, elderly people are sitting, your co-mates are sitting, your friends are sitting, in that way. Fine, you have to address the audience. Fine, a pleasant morning to one and all. Clear? Then, after greeting the audience, start with a quotation, greet the audience, introduce yourself. Sometimes introduction is given in the statement that you are Manav or Mansi of class plus two, write a speech on this topic. So you will be using that name only. If no name is given, then in boards, you don't write your real names. You just write I, ABC of class 12th. Okay. So you'll be writing I, Manav of class 12th. Fine. Stand here to voice my opinion on the topic or express my opinion on the topic dash, whatever topic is given to you. Then sometimes beta announce, while announcing the topic, occasion is also mentioned. Suppose it's Teacher's Day celebration, 26th annual day is going on. Fine. Some alumni meet is going on. Anything. So you have to mention the occasion also. On the occasion of World Environment Day, I would like to voice my opinion on how to conserve environment in that way. Clear? So this should be your first paragraph. All the elements, start with a quotation, greet the audience, introduce yourself, introduce the topic and occasion, announce the topic and occasion. Now comes your second and third paragraph, beta. Let me adjust the camera here. You can see, yes. Introduction part of the speech, beta. Now, while introducing the, topic, it should be catchy. Catchy means it should be attractive and it should be short. Don't, spend too much time in writing introduction that you're not coming to the solutions and problems, fine? So it should be catchy and short. How it can be catchy and short? Sometimes, children start the speech with a rhetoric device. I'll be telling you what is a rhetoric device later on. Or sometimes you can start with announcement of some news headlines also. Fine. Suppose you got a topic on road accidents, increasing road accidents and its reasons. So you start with a 28-year-old died on Jalandhar-Ludhiana road. A whole family died in one of the major accidents near Dash Road in that way. Fine. So you can start in that way that it should look attractive, catchy, and it should capture the attention of the reader or listener. Now, after that, beta, keep on adding facts, data, news excerpts. If you have not started with news excerpt, you can use one or the other news excerpt in between. But it depends on the topic, what sort of topic you have got. Sometimes speech is just about very simple topic, saving environment, fine, use of mobile phones in that way. So then most of the times it has been noticed that problematic topic is given, that the topic which contains problems and it has effects. And if problem is there, causes definitely will be there and solutions you have to give, fine. So what will you do? This is the beta hierarchy that sometimes you forget na what to write. How should I write in a speech? So this is the logical order, fine. In second paragraph, you will be adding facts, data, news excerpts. You can discuss the causes of that problem. You can tell the effects of that problem, fine. Then after that, advantages or disadvantages of that problem. Some topics are very controversial, very sensitive. Such topics, they have both the way I'm giving you the topic technology. Now, technology has advantages because we people, see, I'm talking to you just because of technology. Had it not been there, I would not have even conveyed my ideas to you. So this is the benefit. Disadvantages are that many children these days, they are taking disadvantage of online system. When this online system will be over, most of you will be in the habit of, you know, in that way, you won't be able to understand because you won't be having patience enough. Many students, they cheat also. Fine, you better know what you people are, how you people are taking advantages of this technology. Fine, this is advantage on your part, but actually this is disadvantage. Another one is this is stress levels are increasing, screen time is increased. So this is the disadvantage. So any problem can have advantage and disadvantage depending upon the topic. Clear? So second and third paragraph would be carrying this information. Okay, is it clear? Send me thumbs up so that I can move forward. Come on fast. Okay. So now, beta, fourth paragraph, you need to change paragraphs in any writing skill. Okay. Three paragraphs should be there. More than that can be. Fourth paragraph is give suggestions and give conclusion. Fine. Now you have discussed problems, causes, effects in the previous paragraph. So you have to give suggestions also. Clear? And then you conclude your viewpoint. You can also conclude by giving a quotation. Okay, this is another way. If you remember the words of any famous personality, like Mahatma Gandhi once said, be the change you want to see in the world. Be the change you wish to see in the world. Fine, so I would like to end up with the words of Mahatma Gandhi. Be the change you wish to see in the world, in that way. APJ Abdul Kalam's quote. If you remember, you will be putting in inverted commas. But if it's a general quote, the way I have written here, it is not, you know, said by any famous personality, then you can write that way without putting inverted commas. Clear? Then after that, beta, say thank you at last. You have to say thank you or thanks for being patient listeners. And this is not part of fourth paragraph. That's why I have excluded it from here. Okay. Write thank you on left-hand side after completing the fourth paragraph. It should be clearly visible. It carries marks, one mark directly, half or one. When you get a speech writing for 10 marks, okay? Now, after this, points to remember, I have highlighted in blue color. It says, use first person pronoun I. Now, what happens, most of the children, they forget that they're writing speech. They start writing speech as if they are writing an article. That we should do this, one should do that, people should do this. Fine, then it becomes an article only. Then you say, ma'am, remarks kyun nahi aaye? Speech should be interactive. Fine? Then you'll be writing, I would like to say that. I want to convey. Fine? Let me tell you, my dear friends, my dear mates, this is the high time when we should stress upon this. So you are just using first person pronoun and you are addressing. Second point is keep addressing the audience. Make it a speech, not an article. So in the speech, you keep addressing the audience. My dear mates, my fellows, fine, dear audience. And don't use same word again and again. Clear? My dear audience, my dear friends, dear mates, fellows, fine in that way. So use rhetoric device. Now I told you, I'll be telling you what is rhetoric device. Rhetoric device is when you pose a question to the audience and you yourself give an answer. And it makes your speech interesting also. It breaks the monotony of dull speech. And this is basic element of speech. And it should be there in your speech writing. You can use it in the beginning, in between, or you can even end your speech with a rhetoric device. Sometimes we ask an audience a question and we just say, now, my dear audience, the answer lies in your hand. Your answer, you know the answer to this question. What will be our future without a single drop of water? With this, I bow my head and in that way, clear? So add interesting facts and ideas. Rather than making your speech dull and boring, add interesting facts, data, ideas. Clear? So each and every point is clear to everyone. Have you noted down? I'm giving you a minute. If you anything is left, fine. First paragraph, second paragraph, third paragraph. Last may thank you on the left side, then points to remember. Okay, now show me your notebooks quickly. Those who have noted down, I will be announcing the names. Yes, Vanshika is the first one to switch on the camera. And beautifully presented, Vanshika. Well done. Yes, Lakshit Sharma is the second one to show. Very good, Lakshit. Sukhman Jyot is third to show. Beautifully presented. Then Amarpreet is there. Then we have Vaibhav. Then Saksham Sharma. Anmol, very good, beta. Who else? Rana Gurjeet, very good. Apoorv, Srishti, well done, beta. So these are the students who are, you know, quite regular in attending classes, as well as they note down the work also. So this will be, you know, beta base when you will be preparing for your exam, whether terminal, periodic or final exams. And this speech writing is more than that. It will be helping you even after passing 12th also. So all the points are clear to everyone. Now I would like to share the screen where we would be doing samples. But you have to write one speech. This is your homework. This is your topic, okay? The topic is, nowadays, just about everyone owns a cell phone, but most of the users do not follow even the basic rules of cell phone conduct. They are seen speaking loudly, taking a phone call in the middle of a meeting, or even at a funeral, etc. Write a speech in 150 to 200 words to be delivered in the assembly of your school to appraise the fellow students of cell phone etiquette. In 2011, this question was there in one of the exams on books. Very, you know, interesting topic it is. You might have seen people in the public, they talk so loudly that even everybody is able to listen to the talk. Some people get annoyed and some people, you know, start taking interest in the conversation. That even happens. This is not cell phone etiquette. Secondly, when, you know, they have not mentioned all the etiquettes. Can you tell me any other etiquette while using a phone? They have mentioned a few only. So firstly, you see the format, you will be telling me this topic, very interesting topic it is. Nowadays, almost everyone owns a mobile, but many users have no knowledge of the basic rules of cell phone conduct. Good morning, everyone. IABC, this is the way better if no name is given, okay? You just see, IABC, have come before you all to apprise you of cell phone etiquette. See the spelling of etiquette? Etiquette means manner. It is actually necessary to follow a few guidelines regarding the use of cell phones. Beta, this speech is not a model speech, not an ideal speech. Why? They have not, you know, addressed the audience. We have, yes, addressed the audience, but they have not bifurcated the paragraphs. Number one, find some elements are missing in this. So, their second paragraph should be from here. Your cell phone does not have to go everywhere you go. This is the mentality of people that wherever we go, we have to carry our cell phone. There are times when you should never answer your cell phone, especially in the places of worship and funeral homes. At the very best, they should be on the vibrate mode. If, you know, some people, they pretend that they are the, you know, VIPs and even PM and CM that they cannot even do without phone. And even people, if you do not respond, the person says, okay, the person has not picked up my phone. It means something bad is there. Deliberately, he is not picking my phone. We people are not having patience enough. Maybe the person is stuck somewhere. Maybe the person, fine, in that way. So I give you one example. Yesterday only, I was about to, you know, I was out somewhere. And I was about to reach home and I was stuck in traffic. I wanted to share the test exactly at 5 p.m. You were having your test. So I was so in a hurry, but it could lead to some mishappening also if I would, you know, increase the speed to reach home. But then I thought it's okay. Within 5 minutes, I would be reaching. So I reached at 5 p.m. and exactly at 5:07, 7 minutes late, you can say. I shared the test with you all, you know that. Fine, but sometimes it happens. It can happen with any one of us. Fine. So be courteous to others, right off not being disturbed by your megaphone range voice. Yeah. And second, people just keep on showing their brands. If they are having the phone of Apple, they keep on showing to others. Yes, yes, we are having. Fine. Cell phone etiquette. Cell phone is not to show off to others. You know, that best part is best phone I feel is than that Nokia, that 1100. Fine. I'm not promoting any brand. I'm just saying that, you know, phone with buttons, that life is best when you want to talk to your, you can say people you're talking. But these days we people, you know, after even online education, online learning, we all people are becoming slaves to this phone. So telephonic manners, be courteous to others. Do not have long conversations. Fine, some people keep on talking for hours. I don't know how. Then if a person is talking to you, rather than looking straight into the eyes of the person, you are just looking at your cell phone. This is also one of the bad manners. Not cell phone etiquette, okay? And if your phone rings while you're driving, wait till you have pulled over before your answer return the call. While driving, never ever do this. And people, you know, they're using Bluetooth. They say that, okay, we are using Bluetooth, we can pick up the phone. No. Even if you're using the Bluetooth and you are driving a car, your attention gets diverted. It can lead to fatal accidents. You know, most of the accidents in India and in abroad or anywhere, in abroad too, there is a rule that you can't talk on phone. But in India, most of the accidents are occurring just because of this bad habit. You know, here even I have seen people driving the two wheelers and their head is like this. Phone chahe gir jaye, khud gir jaye, but unko phone sunne. This is the way we are doing it. This is also not cell phone etiquette. Your life and the life of the people around is very much value than your phone call. Be a responsible cell phone user. Be aware of your surroundings before making or receiving a call, or have respect for those around you. This will help others to appreciate your good judgment. And if it is emergency, park your car outside. Park your Activa outside. If you're not stuck in the traffic, fine. Then listen to whosoever is calling you. Thank you at last, fine. So what is the difference? They have divided this. They have just writing the speech in one go, but you will be dividing your speech in four paragraphs. Points they have given in a very good way. Yeah, we are left with 3-4 minutes. Let me show you more examples. Yoga can help in maintaining good health. What sort of topics you get in boards, Vita? Note down, education, fine, education. Now in education, it can be education rights for all, women education, equal rights of education, fine, increasing trend of higher education, special education for special children. So one topic is multifaceted topics. Then you have environment related issues, electricity related issues, health related, like yoga is there, importance of exercise is there, fine. And these days COVID is being spread like anything. So health related issues or ailments related topics are commonly there. The next topic is technology, fine, impact of technology, stress on eyes and in our lives in that way. Then after technology, you have, you can say equal rights, then child labor, you can say, fine, many topics are there. Basically, water scarcity is there, or any social problem, child abuse is there, robbery, you know, recently robbery cases are going on at very fast pace, even in our city. So robbery can be one of the topics, clear, or it can be very simple, like importance of yoga, to very tricky one, talking about very technical, you can say, these days, but the way they have given you cell phone etiquettes, online teaching learning etiquettes is one more topic, which I personally am suggesting you. I have seen many people, they do not have etiquettes of attending either the class or fine in that way. One should have manners how to attend the class. If you are switching on the video, make sure nobody is around you, nobody is disturbing you. And sometimes accidentally your video is on and you're lying in the bed. I've seen many a time when students send me messages, ma'am, sorry, I was not well. Is this etiquette of attending the online class? One should have formal setup, chair and table. You know that now, it's been more than a year now you have been doing this. Arrange one table and chair for you and a silent corner in the house that where nobody disturbs you. Fine. There should be manners to attend online classes also. So I'm giving you that topic. Your homework is etiquettes of attending online classes. Fine, I changed this because I've already discussed all the points of cell phone etiquette. So this is your homework, etiquettes of attending online classes. So I would be giving a chance to one of you next week to speak here in this class. Okay, any doubt to anyone? Send me thumbs up quickly. If everything is clear to you, class is about to end. Anmol, Srishti, Rana Guji, Sakshin Sharma, Lakshay, Dapur, Sukhmanjot, Abhirup. Abhirup is there, see. Abhirup, you did not show me your notebook. Divyaleen, you have not shown me notebook or not sending any thumbs up. There are students who never, they are just there. Jagraj is there, but he never responds. It means something is wrong. Rasika, are you there? Yes, Vaibhav, you are there. I have seen it. See, I'm just naming Harnoor Singh. He's not there. Gaurav. These students are just, they have logged in, but they are not there. See, this is the loophole of technology. So no doubts are there? Okay, beta. Fine.